So, for execution of our project, we first need the input images. So we have here five input images. Additional images can also be put here and used, but we are keeping it to a small amount of image. Here in lung field SED L images, these are accounting for the left images of the lung to judge what is normal and what is not. And subsequently, in R images, these are accounting for the right images, right lung images that are supposed to be normal. In the support folders, we have the functions and methods that we are using to implement our base model and also the additional model that we will explain. So, for the execution of our project, we go to the lung main function and we run the function. We are told to select one of the images, and I am going to select this one for example. Then you can see the execution time is being shown here. This is the execution time. This is the Jaccard index. So, the Jaccard index is in the order of 0.91 and the Dice coefficient is 0.95. As much as it is closer to 1, the lung is said to be in a normal state and condition. If the values of both the parameters are closer to 0, then the lung needs to be looked at, and this is an anomaly that is foreshadowing in the lung chest radiography. Here are the five images that have come out by that one input, and the first figure is of the input image, the second figure is of the structure edge detected boundary mapping, the third is the use of ultrametric contour map, which specifies the contour with a red line and traces it basically. The fourth one is the manual mask, which will be explained later in this video, and the fifth is the segmented mask. This is the output of our model, and this is the reduced, the size of the input chest X-ray is this one, and the average running time of the SED UCM is this much, and the further explanation of the code will be done by Ananya.
I, Ananya Gupta, going to explain lung main functions. In this function, we are doing SED model, which is structured edge detection model. In this function, first of all, the first command is clear all, close all. This command is used to delete or clear all the commands that are open in MATLAB currently. The next is add path support. Add path is a function in a MATLAB which is used to add the path of the current folder. The support is a folder in which there are many inbuilt functions which are already defined. The next is CD images. CD images is, CD means changing the directory. Now we are changing the directory to the images folder. From that we are getting our source image. The UIGetFile is a function in a MATLAB which will display a dialog box from which we are open one or more files. So from that we are selecting our source image, Now CD, we are changing the directory to the current one. Input CXR is a variable in which we are reading our image into that. If size input CXR comma 3 is greater than 1, that means we want a image in grayscale image. If the size of the image is greater than the 1 or 2, then we will convert the image from the RGB to gray. Now, after all this, we are loading the SED model. For the image segmentation, mainly we have to define the training directories, in which there are so many of training folders. For that, we have to create the model and ages train for detecting the ages. These all are the codes for that. Now we are setting the SED model prediction so that our images would be more smooth and more enhanced. For this, there are many parameters which can help us to do that. First is that multi-scaling. Multi-scaling will help us to control the evaluation of the curve. The second is sharpen. This will help to sharpen the image. The third one is entries evaluation. It will set the how many trees we are using for evaluation per location. Then next is the threads, how many maximum number of threads we are using. And buffer is parallelizes the image if there is a sufficient memories. And super pixel we are using for the iterative clustering algorithm. And deep case mask is used for the mask parameter. Now we are doing the TIC. TIC is generally a stopwatch timer. It will measure the performance of our SED-UCM structured edge detection procedure. So we are iterating it for 1 to 10 times. These all are the parameters which I described earlier. These all are iterating over the image for 1 to 10 times, so that we can calculate our average time performance. And we are TOC is a command which can provide us the elapsed time since the TIC was used. The average running time will be printed by the fprintf method. We are dividing the segment time by 10, so because we are iterating it over 10 times. And we are also displaying the size of the input. Now we are showing our input image in a figure from the function IAMSO. IAMSO is a function in image processing so that we can show our image. Next, we are showing the SED boundary map. And next, we are showing the input CXR. And hold on function is a property of the hold on function is used to hold the current input so that we are applying more function to it. And we are contouring by using the UCM map, and comma R is applying the red regions to it. Now we are changing the directory. Changing the directory to the left images and the right images. We are resizing it so that our input image or left or right images will be same. And we are combining it together for further analysis. Then we are doing the manual masking. IM2BW is changing the image to the black and white so that the manual masking will be shown. And then after that, we are doing the lung segmented mask, and we are calling the Jacquard index and the dice coefficient method in the main function.
I am Akash, and I am going to explain extension of SED model. The file name which I am explaining is extn_sed.m. So our base paper is implemented in the program sed_seg.m, and to add our functionality and our input into the project work, we have created the extension file of the standard SED. So starting with it, now the first three commands are for clearing the directories and the screen, which Ananya has explained previously. We are adding a path support which contains all the functions that are used in the working of our program. So the support folder contains all the functionalities and small functions that we need to use. Then we are adding that support into this code. Now, image detection needs a variable that is model underscore smooth underscore image that is initialized and set to 0. Then we are changing the directory with cd, and by changing the directory we are selecting images. Images is a folder where all the input images that we acquired are stored. Then we are reading the image, the selected input image file, and J and P are the planes of image. So the user interface that is created to select the image is UI. With UI function, we are selecting the image for the planes J and P. Now we are resizing the image because the image works on a specific size. After doing that, we are changing the directory and going back to the main directory. So 256 cross 256 is the size of the resizing element, and the input image is being scaled to 256 cross 256 pixel size. Now we are creating the original image document, which is titled as original image. The next thing that we need to do is the conversion of RGB image to grayscale, and the input is converted by the RGB to gray function into a grayscale image. Again, the input image is converted to double precision and applied. In the next line, we are introducing the first new element that we have implemented is the Gaussian filter. What the Gaussian filter does, it is that it removes the noise, the blurriness or the mess that is present into the picture. So it gives enhancement and clarity upon its usage. The Gaussian function is one of the functions that is mentioned in the support library, support folder. The next point of interest is T equal to I minus L blur. So these are the working of the Gaussian filter and determining the parameters and mentioning the parameters that are to be used in the latest in determining T. So T is being used in a function. The function mat to gray is being used with parameter T, and is equated with T. So what this mat to gray is doing, it is setting the values of A min and A max to maximum and minimum values in T. The function basically does is it converts a matrix into image. A new variable, model SEG, it is parsed with 0 as model underscore smooth underscore image was initialized to 0. So it has been equated here. And then mu, lambda and vector parameters are calculated. These parameters are for active contour function. So these are working for the these are taken into consideration for working of active contour model, and using that active contour model as an umbrella term, in turn it is being used for the snake segmentation. The calculated parameters are now loaded into the snake segmentation process. Applying snake segmentation into image and with the vector parameters. Now u equal to snake segmentation, the parameters that we are passing is the input image, and applying the vector parameters into the input image. This function is working as that. So again, resizing is being applied to the to u, which is our snake segmentational processes variable. Then threshold calculation function is being defined. So how do we mention the threshold? TH is the variable that is being used for threshold, and OTSU taking parameter u. That OTSU is a threshold calculation function that is adjusted as per our project and is defined in the support files. What that does basically is it has a set of equation to modify the threshold calculating the parameters, and through this threshold image the image is converted to black and white and precision is increased with double. Using double, it gives more precision. Now zeros in image processing represent black, so this function zeros, g equal to zeros 256,256, is essentially accounting for a concept that I will image by executing this program. Now what is happening here is, while the segmentation is happening, there will be existing input image, but other parts will have a black background. So initially a black background is all that is present, and minus the input image will give the output of this process. That is, if we take a black image, match with input image, and final segmentation will show. So putting the mask and tracing method to see what remains. This is being explained in this process. And then changing the directory to L image and R images. So L image account for the left side from of the lung, left lung, that is from the data set, and right, and R images is for the right side for lung images from the data set. And what we are doing is, it goes, so mentioning this the command directory, it goes to the left images first and then reads the images, then converts them into same size as the input chest x-ray, then same for the right. And the x variable and the y variable are accounting for the left and right subsequently, and adding both of them up is giving us the manual mask. And when this manual mask is converted into black and white, then it is giving us the segmented mask. And similarly, we are calculating the Jaccard index and the Dias coefficient for this as well.
Hello, I'm going to explain about Jaccard index and Dias coefficient, which are used in our project, which are the basic building block to find the similarities and dissimilarities of different two sets, which are the our images which are converted in the matrix form. Here we are getting the get Jaccard function and the get Dias coefficient function having the in parameter of S and T, which are the manual task, manual mask, and the segmented mask in predefined calculation. Here we are computing the Dias coefficient, which measure the similarities between two binary 0 and 1 vector form, or we can call as set A and B. For example, to compute the Dias coefficient between two sets or network community partition, first we have to assign each link to the corresponding set community, where this can be implemented by calling getCommunityMatrix.m function, which is predefined in the MATLAB IDE. In this method to our code, then we will get the binary value to the corresponding matrix, where we are extracting the sub-diagonal element in form of vector, where these vectors are required to input A and B sets or vector form. The other alternative measures of similarity between sets are to finding the formula from getNMI function to get the normalized mutual information which is free from duplicate value that is used to assign the matrix to have more efficient and more knowledgeful and more information about the set. The Jaccard index function getJaccard, where the input values are A, binary vector of A, and B, which is the binary set vector of B, which are giving the output of dice coefficient. Between other alternative measures of similarity, sets are calculated. If the n argin is less than 2, the function requires the two input vectors. To have the similarities and dissimilarity, we must have two sets to be comparison. If the set A is equal to 0 plus sum A is equal to 1, which is length less than the length of A, then there will be error that input A must be in the binary form. Either set A or either set B must be in a binary form. If the sum B is equal to 0 or sum B is equal to 1, which is less than the length B, the same, the input B must be in the binary form. And then the dice coefficient have the formula 2 into sum of A dot star multiplication of B, which is divided by the sum of A plus B, which is nothing but the dice coefficient gives the formula that the 2 times of the area which had the some similarities, or we can call it as the area which had the overlap. So 2 times the area of overlapped area upon divided by the total area, which is 2 times the area overlapped, the one which is predicted area or the one which is the predefined area. After the matrix calculation, which is converting the image into digital data, which is in matrix form, we will be using the Jaccard index, which is essentially the number of both sets. The number in both sets are divided by either sets and then multiply by the 100. This will produce the percentage of measurement of similarities between the two sample sets. For example, Jaccard index, which is denoted by J, of set A and B are equal to, or as given as a formula, A intersection of B divided by A union of B. Jaccard index are extracted from the formula get Jaccard of A and B, which is predefined in the MATLAB, where we are computing the Jaccard index, a measure of similarity between two binary vectors, vector sets A and B. To compute the Jaccard index between the network community partition, we have to assign the link to the corresponding community. For example, get community matrix.m, then binarize the corresponding matrix and extract the sub-diagonal index. Now, the Jaccard index will found the similarity coefficient, which is the statistic used in the understanding the similarities between sample sets of different matrices form. The measurement emphasizes similarities between finite sample sets and is formally defined as the size of intersection divided by the size of the union of the sample sets. Hello.
Hello, my name is Isha Mishra and I will be explaining the segmented edge detection using snake model. The function, the code here, it describes the function y is equal to snake segmentation intensity and the vector parameters. The maximum intensity is equal to 256, which is the maximum image intensity. the image which are we using as an input image. The input image is being processed using model smooth image is equal to 0. Now the function starts with y and x axis, ny comma nx, the size of the image. The image with intensity range is 0 to 1, and the next intensity is equals to 1 plus maximum intensity into intensity 0 is from 1 to maximum intensity. So here we are pointing out the intensity of the image which we are using as an input image of a lung x-ray. Now we will compute the edge detector function. Using edge detector function is equal to 2 if use edge detector is equal to 0. Here the smooth input image will be using the contour points for the smooth image edge detector. Now the Gaussian filter here is used FS special. Gaussian function is used on the NY NX axis to calculate the gradient of the smooth image. To calculate the gradient of the smooth image, of which we will be explaining the edge detector function. The Gaussian filter explains the Gaussian filter explains us the gradient of the smooth image or the input image we will be using as a X-ray image, and this Gaussian filter is further analyzed as the edge detector function in this code. Now the next code gives us a segmentation code which will be using for the max function. Model segmentation is equal to vector parameters, model segmentation is equal to model smooth image. And the active, and now in this code we will be using the meg function. Max function here explains the snake model along with the active contour model, and the edge detector here points out the points, contour points or the Cartesian points in which we will be joining and making a red line detecting the edges of the input image as given in the code, in the first part of the code. And the model segmentation here involves the mean in and mean out using the active contour minimization max, single image 0 and single image as a Gaussian filter and single image as vector parameters. These three functions has been used for the active contour modeling. First is the image, and second is the when we apply the Gaussian filter, and next is the parameters as to apply for the edge detection. The next is model segmentation is equal to model texture image. Texture image involves the P in and P out and FT, texture feature. This is a texture feature in which we will be pointing out the contour points of the image using the red lines or the detecting the contour points of the lung's image. Now this function ends, and we'll display the result using the model segmentation. The model, if model segmentation is equal to model smooth image, this is the final inside mean and outside mean, including both the inside mean, all the points of the lung image, all the Cartesian points have been analyzed, and those final mean and the input means have been collaborated together. And here it is written as display mean in and mean out, the subplot 122 and inshow unit image reference, title segmentation and line width. In this model segmentation, we using the snake model in the first code. The first code explains the snake model code in which we have applied the image intensity ranges, and also we are pointing out the contour points or the Cartesian points on the input image. And after these, using the segmentation code, we segmented out the points which are abnormal or something related to with the image, or which are coming at the edges of the image. So using this images and using these images and these Cartesian points, we take out their mean, the inside mean and the final mean. They are included together in mean in and mean out, in mean in and mean out, and therefore it is, and therefore we get the image detection using the snake model, and the segmentation we receive is using this.